Hey there, Adam Savage in my cave, answering questions about my time on Mythbusters. And Evan Currie wants to know, when you did the gunfire into water myth, this was the myth of, from like Saving Private Ryan, you see the bullets heading through the water and through soldiers. And the myth, and yet, frequently in action movies, we see the hero out in the water at night and the bad guys are shooting him. He puts his head underwater and he seems to be totally impervious to bullets. That was the myth. This Evan Currie says, I noted that the high powered rifles actually penetrated less than the lower powered ones. This is absolutely true. The 9mm handgun bullet went way, way farther in the water than the 50 caliber bullet. And that is because of what Evan's next sentence is. That was specifically because the bigger and faster moving bullet expends more of its energy faster because it's bigger. And it does that for a specific reason. A bullet has been built to, this is a gruesome term of art, a bullet has been built to mechanically couple with us. That is what they mean. I don't know if you've ever heard this, but a bullet, like, to do its job effectively, a bullet's going to enter you, and then it's going to leave you, and if it's designed correctly, it's going to leave you carrying as much of you with it as it can. And to do that, they've designed the lead and the construction of a bullet to mechanically couple with you. So that means the instant the bullet hits your flesh, it's been calibrated to start to split apart when it meets you, and as it splits apart, it starts damaging more and more of you. I know, this is horrifyingly gruesome. This is the science of bullets. Thus, the faster it's going, the more energy it's expending on that impact and the more damage it's going to do. But you and I are like mostly water. Ugly bags of mostly water, to quote my favorite Star Trek line. We're like 70% water. And so the bullet that's been built to mechanically couple with us also mechanically couples really well with water, which makes total sense. But these are not the things that Evan Currie is concerned with. He wants to know, did you guys ever consider testing whether the shockwave from something like a 50 caliber rifle might actually be deadly, even if the bullet never reached the target? That is a great question. It is a really great question and not one that we considered. One of the reasons we didn't consider this is like season two, I think, of Mythbusters. Maybe season three. It's really early days. So we weren't yet the scientist engineers that we became. At that moment, I think we were much more sort of in the maelstrom of making the show. And those kind of ancillary questions, which are so delightful to entertain and to potentially film narratives about, those weren't occurring to us on every story. That is a completely great question. Let me see if I can answer it. I'm just trying to see if I have a point of view about whether or not it would happen. I don't think that the shockwave from a 50 caliber bullet in water could harm you unless you're like right next to it. So shockwave propagation drops off fairly quickly. And to give you an example, a grenade won't kill you from more than like 10 or 12 feet away. Like all of that shockwave and shrapnel is meant to do its job in a very small space, a very localized space. I might have my numbers slightly wrong. Forgive me, military people, if I'm off in that. But the overall theme is right? Like a grenade in that corner of the room isn't going to kill someone in that corner of the room. And shockwave propagation in water is different than it is in air, which we tested when we did the story about the underwater explosion. People in the military used to be told if a depth charge is going to go off in the water, you are better off lying on your back in the water rather than being immersed in the water because the shockwave will have less effect on you. But does that tell us anything about what a 50 caliber bullet shockwave would do? See, having detonated a lot of blasting caps in water and seeing that like we didn't even break the box we'd built to hold that, I have a hard time imagining. But then the question is there a bullet powerful enough to kill you by its shockwave in water? Or is there a projectile? And that's another question I'm not exactly positive of. I tend to think no. I tend to think that the drop off in the pressure wave would be really significant in the water. And so my feeling would be that in order to harm you from the shockwave, it would literally have to be traveling like right past you, like really close to you, in which case you're lucky to be alive. Yeah, we hadn't considered it. And the reason was because that was early days. Thank you. I wish I had more of an answer for you, Evan, but it is a terrific question and it's a completely valid one. And one, if we were still making the show, absolutely might make a revisit, might make an excellent revisit because you could test lots of different types of shockwaves. My sense is that a 50 cal bullet would have to be incredibly close and that you might have to find an even bigger gun to find one that could harm you while you were underwater. But of course, that's how we'd finish the episode, right? We'd go get the biggest projectile shooting thing that anyone would give us access to in whatever desert location we could find to fire it and some kiddie pool, and Buster would get the shockwave of his life. Yeah, that's how that would have gone. Evan Currie, thank you so much for such a provocative and delightful question. Tested patrons, your questions are awesome. Keep submitting them and I will keep answering them in this forum. Thank you guys so much. I will see you next time.